Hi, this is Thorsten Schmidt and welcome to the NMS Prime channel. Today I want to speak about my personal coding advices and I want to give you a short introduction of how the development process of NMS Prime actually works. This video is for people who are interested in becoming coding members of our team. And for all other guys, if you are interested in some background stuff about the project, then maybe just stay. Okay, first of all, my personal coding advices. As you can see in the background, I've got three monitors. So the more monitors you have, the better coder you are. No, joke. But working with at least two monitors is really cool, because what I did most of the time is that I have one monitor where I have my coding editor open, and on the other monitor I have, for example, the www page of the NMS Prime project where I'm coding. So this is really cool. And the third monitor maybe is for the documentation or for some, let's say, to keep track what I did or what I do. I put it on the third monitor. So this is for me perfect. I will jump in this a little bit later. And of course, as you can imagine, my operating system is Linux. I use a normal Ubuntu system, which is, I guess, the latest long-time version. I'm not quite sure if it's 14 or no, it's 16 at the time, I guess. And in NMS Prime, when we develop, we've got one core server, so it's a real server. And at this server, I don't know, there are about 10 or 15 virtual machines. And at these virtual machines, any of these virtual machines is assigned to one developer. And every developer has, for example, at least one different Git tree. So our project is hosted at GitHub. Yeah, as I explained, this is our real machine with the many different virtual machines. And this is my personal development machine at the time. And what I do is that I directly connect to the NMS Prime directory via the SSHFS file system. And this is really easy. And this is cool stuff, because I can use a normal graphical editor. And now I want to show you this process. So I've just opened a normal command line, and then I've typed in SSHFS. I want to connect as root user, because I need write access to the directory which I want to connect with. And this is the var www or var www directory, and I've linked it into my home directory under the space of SSHFS, and that's it. It does not ask for a password, because I'm working with SSH certificates. And what you see next, or what you will see next, is that now I have linked the directory var www of my development machine to my local file system, and inside of NMS Prime is the entire project. So what I mostly do next is that I just want to use SSH to check maybe at which branch my Git repository is. So I jump into the official directory, and maybe let's check it out if there are some untracked changes. You see that I'm actually on the branch small ticket improvements, and I've got still some untracked work inside my Git repository. Now I have opened my Sublime browser. And what is always recommended is, when you work with SSHFS, then just first refresh your folders. And now I'm still working with all the files that are on my server. And the next thing, of course, is that I need to jump to my browser and to get to my NMS Prime instance. And for this purpose, I have still checked my IP address in the background. And now I've just copied it, and I go to the browser. Back in my Sublime editor, just to show you one cool feature, is that, for example, if I want to jump into some controller, I can just type in Control P, and now I've got a real-time search into the file. So for example, I want to jump to the tree topography controller. Now I'm here, and maybe let's say I want to jump to a special function. I also can use Control P and say maybe just go to the function show, and now I'm here. Sublime has very, very crazy tools. It's really a cool project, so maybe just check it out if you don't know it yet. I guess there are many cool YouTube videos about it, so I don't want to speak on this now. One final word about how we prioritize our work. So about every week or every 2 weeks, we sit together with all our core development members, and we are talking about the actual open projects and about the next steps. And then we kind of rank and prioritize our next works and assign it to the developers. So, thanks for watching. If you want to see more of the stuff, maybe just comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to our newsletter. Use NMS Prime. We think it's a cool project. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.